Hey, welcome to the shop. So today I wanted to share with you my most recent update to the MPCNC. Usually I post this on my blog, but I wanted to try something a little different today and put together a video. Recently I was doing a simple cut on a piece of 3/4 inch plywood, and I was getting a lot of vibrations, a lot of chatter. I broke 3 end mills for what should have been a simple, straightforward operation. This forced me to look over the machine and deal with some issues that I had been ignoring. There were cracks in the XY gantry. There were broken pieces that were held on by the tension of the bolts. There's also been a new hardware version that came out, which meant pretty much a complete replacement of all the plastic parts. I decided to start with the core and work my way outwards. This isn't exactly recommended, but I figured let's give it a shot, see what kind of results we can get, and I'll replace as necessary. So first with printing the core itself. It's a pretty large piece, a lot of plastic, and very long print times. I've seen people reporting anywhere between 30 and 50 hours of printing just to get a single component. I wanted to see if I could do this a little faster. So I replaced my stock 0.4mm nozzle with a 0.8mm nozzle, which cut my print time down to between 10 and 12 hours. It was a good thing that I did this, because my first print failed about 90% in. My dual extruder got caught somewhere in the print and caused a layer shift, so everything above a certain height was offset from where it was supposed to be. So I had to go and print this thing again. And if I had been waiting for, 30, 40 hours to get this done, I would have been really frustrated. 12 hours, not so bad. I set it up, it ran overnight, and it seems like a really solid piece. So once it was printed, I took apart the old XY gantry. I tried to salvage the bearings and the lock nuts that came with the machine. Most of the pieces came off pretty easily, but there were two that I had to clip the plastic on one end, and to get them around the rail, I used a heat gun to melt and soften the plastic just enough to where I could bend it from around the rail. With the original gantry gone, I could start assembling the new core onto the rails. Now what you're supposed to do is you're supposed to build the core separately and then insert the rails to where the bearings will ride on them. I did this backwards. I built it around the existing rails because I was trying not to disassemble the entire machine. This isn't proper procedure, but I wanted to see if I could get it done this way, and I think I succeeded. So with the core assembled and in place, I wanted to lower the entire machine. I think I had a little too much travel in my Z-axis, which was giving me a little too much flex in the overall design. I cut it down from about 6 inches to 3 inches, shrunk the Z-axis, and shortened the legs that the machine stands on. With the hardware in place, I wanted to work on the wiring a little bit. Over the years, I've added a couple cables to drive different tools. I have 3 5-volt PWM lines, 2 that are dedicated for servos, 1 that's dedicated for a laser, and some 12-volt wiring with an XT60 connector. I clipped all of these wires, soldered them together, and added some heat shrink tubing, and I'm really happy with how clean the machine looks now. With all of the hardware put together, I was ready to test out the machine. I went around and tightened everything up to the specifications in the instructions. I then put together some simple 2-inch by 2-inch blocks that I was going to cut out of 3/4 inch pine. The first thing I wanted to figure out is what feed rate I could use. I set the DeWalt to its lowest setting, which is about 16,000 RPM, and I put a single flute spiral end mill in place with a 2.5mm depth of cut. So I tested this out at 30, 60, 80, and 100 inches per minute. Surprisingly, it cuts better the faster I go. I would be happy running at 80 and 100 inches per minute. So there's still some more testing I want to do, some more pieces I need to cut out, and some more parameters that I can tune with the machine. But I'm really excited to be moving on to the latest version of the hardware and making the machine more capable and more reliable. I suppose that's about it for this video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.